Wake up and smell the coffee, Mr. LaRusso.
Extreme situations require extreme measures.
Hey guys, welcome back to Cobra Kai Karate. Welcome to a brand new video, our fourth episode inside the Analyzing Every Character from Season 4. Today we're doing Daniel LaRusso, and guys, next week we'll have Miguel, and that'll be a good one, so make sure to stay tuned. Well, not next week, next time I do it, probably like 2 days, I don't know, it'll come out eventually. But we're gonna do Daniel LaRusso's character arc in Season 4, so let's just get into that video right now. First off, let me say, I love Daniel LaRusso. I know a lot of people don't like him in the Cobra Kai series, they like him more in the Karate Kid. I liked him a lot more in the Karate Kid than Cobra Kai, but he's still a great character. I think Season 4, he was not the nicest guy, but I just still think it was a good character arc. So I'm going to tell you about from the beginning to the end of his whole character arc, so let's just get into it. In the beginning of this, he wants to work with Johnny, and he wants to train people, but he still is really set on believing that defense and Miyagi-Do is the right training for karate. That's one thing that he believes in very much, and I think he also starts growing a really good bond with Miguel. And I think the reason for that is because I think Miguel and Daniel have a lot of the same stuff. You know, they really came from nothing. They learned karate. I'm talking about him in the first Karate Kid. So I think his Miguel relationship was really good, but yeah, and then of course Johnny starts getting jealous, and also Johnny starts teaching other stuff he does not want to do, and he just thinks like, look, like this is not the one. Like, I think Miyagi-Do is the one for it. And then he teaches him some Eagle Fang, and I think he really enjoyed that, because like Terry Silver said, you don't want to admit you always had a little Cobra Kai in you, and I think he kind of did. I think he really enjoyed that. And also, let's just get to the point when Terry Silver comes to visit him. When Terry Silver comes to visit, he flips out. He's like, he did not like that, because you all know what happened to Karate Kid 3 and everything happened there. It was just bad. And he thinks Johnny wants to go in there and just take him seriously with offense. He says, no, we have to do a defense. Miyagi-Do is only going to beat Terry Silver. That's what we're going to do. He disagrees, so he says, all right, we'll fight. And he does it. Of course, he wakes up, he's like really drunk, and he's like, okay. But he still does it because he's like, listen, Mr. Miyagi, I think that's the right thing to do. If it's not, please forgive me, but I have to do this, because he really strongly believes in this and Miyagi-Do. He really believes in it. So they fight, and of course, just a draw. But after that, when Hawk or Eli comes over with the hair, of course, I'm sure he feels really sorry, but he basically thinks we should not attack, and Johnny says we could, so they eventually left. And then when the stuff starts happening, like with Sam, when she's striking Johnny, he gets like really angry, because he like, that's like his daughter, and he really like believed in her training with Miyagi-Do. He's been doing it ever since she was really young, and now she's doing that. Now he's just angry. He's all frustrated. And when when he finds out that Anthony is basically being a bully, I think he feels a lot of guilt on himself, and also because he realized like, I've not given Anthony the attention I should be doing. He was focusing more on Sam and Cobra Kai, and I think he felt a lot of guilt. But he was also very angry at, because as you can see, he was very angry at Anthony. And when the tournament comes and he still really believes in defense and he thinks that's how they're gonna win, when he sees that when Robbie's trying to use Miyagi-Do, when Cobra Kai's using Miyagi-Do, and when Sam starts doing offense, that's what makes him really angry. And then she says, well, I got a choice. And then that's when you realize, like, Mr. Miyagi never wanted you to just teach Miyagi-Do. He wanted you to teach your own way. That was one of his most important lessons, and you didn't do it. So he went to go get Johnny, basically saying, like, look, I just really, Mr. Miyagi changed my life. He was more of a father to me, and I just wanted to carry on his legacy, because you know he's dead now, and then he really wants to carry on the legacy. As you can see, he went over Miyagi-Do, and but he's like, that's our important lesson, so we have to be Cobra Kai offense, defense, we have to be this is the way that Mr. Miyagi would want to have it, and that's what he's thinking. So they do it, and then when they lose, that's when he was just like, that broke his heart. And I think he was like really bitter. Like, he's like, I'm not closing down a dojo to these people. So he calls up Chosen. He's like, look, we have to beat him. I don't care about the deal. This is about the future of this valley, the next generation, and this generation now. We have to stop it before it gets out of hand. Now that Terry Silver is taking full force, we have to stop it with all full force of Miyagi-Do. And this season 5, Daniel, is going to be a beast. And it's just going to be great training with Chosen. It's just going to be such a good season. Well, guys, that's the video. Put in your comments what you think about Daniel LaRusso and his character arc in season 4. I personally think he had a really good character arc. Oh, one more thing. I had to play it. That one scene where he says quiet with all that stuff with Anthony. That's what he needed. Because I think he's taking it too light on Anthony a couple times. And I think that's what he needed. Like Johnny says, sometimes the kids need a little bit of aggression. So yeah, guys, put in your comments what you think is going to happen next and what you think about his character arc. And guys, next episode, we will have Miguel. And then I think I might do Hawk, Robbie, Sam, Tori, Anthony, Kenny. I might even do Amanda, Carmen. I don't know. I want to keep this going for a while because we don't have a lot of season 5 stuff, so I'm trying to keep it stuff fresh. And I'm also working on some recreations. But anyway, guys, this is the video. Thank you guys for watching. And remember, extreme situations require extreme measures.